The reason that we are having the Avestai Koshi Afson is that this Avestai is going to be recited and praised when we are renewing our Koshi. And Koshi is a long strand of cord that we are pulling around that Sidre. Now, you may want to know exactly what is the meaning, a definition for Sidre and Koshi. So that's why I'm sharing right now with you guys a little bit talking about Sidre and Koshi, and then we can go to the particular prayer of that. What is Sidre? Sidre is just a symbolism. There are not necessarily exactly what we are saying it, but this one, most of the Zoroastrian are wearing underwear, like under any clothes. It's a white shirt, which is like a t-shirt, but is very light and is particularly from a white cotton, or sometimes in the past it was from the silk. This particular light dress, which is a loose garment, and it comes particularly in white color, which is representing about the purity. As like any other things, any stains or something is easily going to be shown on a white dresses. That's the perfect meaning, because of the Sidre should be in a white color. The one important things of this Sidre is doesn't have any seams on the shoulder. Any shirt that you are going to find, you are going to see some seams or something that has been sewed between the front and the back. But this is very interesting, the way that they are creating the Sidre. Literally, they are folding the fabric or material, and then they're cutting it from the side, and then start only sewing from the two sides beneath this, beneath the sleeves. The reason that they're saying it, if you as someone wearing this Sidre, you are the current generation. The front representing of our front and future generation, and the past representing our ancestor and our previous generation. Therefore, this one is a something that we are wearing as a Zoroastrian. However, there has a, some section that we are coloring and numbering over here. It's about 9 different areas. Quickly, I'm going to touch on these ones that you can understand. It's not like any other also t-shirt that you can buy from Target or somewhere. It has to have been sewed by some certain people who knows that, and they are sewing it, and you can ask for it, purchase it, and buying and wearing it. Again, this loose t-shirt, it has those sleeves, with the sleeves is representing for work and effort. And that is being sewed. Sometimes for women, it doesn't have, so it shows like this hash sign for women, versus for men, it has like this extra sleeves, which is still is a short sleeve. And the front, there is something like a rectangle, and in the back, like semicircle. The semicircle are saving all the potential goodies. Again, remember, these are all symbolism. There is not an actual things, right? It's just symbolizing that all the future good deeds are kind of saved over here. And you as a person wearing it, you're activating those good deeds. And in the front, all the good deeds that has been performed are going to be accumulated, and it's going to be saved over here. And you as a person carrying it on, this Sidre and all the good deeds. At the same time, there is a one interesting thing is that here on the very bottom, it has one straight seam, which in the back, which in the past, it was showing that it was kind of like a space for carrying a dragger or dart. When the people were going outside for hunting or for agriculture or something, they were carrying something in case something is going to harm them. But particularly in Zoroastrian, we are having that seam, but we are definitely closing it. It's not an open spot. Just to remind you that this religion is a religion of a peace. And that's another thing. One more time, here is like a triangle sewing between the front and in the back to remind you that the front generation or the future generation and the past ancestor are touching together through you. So you, who you are wearing this on, you're bridging between these two generations. Again, this is a Sidre. In Avesta language, we are calling it Bahumana Vastra, which is covering the good thoughts nowadays. And then, as I mentioned, it's come from white cotton or white Tiffany. I'm going to let you guys read it on your own, not to take away the time from this class, but it's explaining all those nine stitching seams and what's the meaning of that. At the end of the day, what we need to remember, what is Sedre, is this white Sedre symbolizes the purity of thought and reminds one to be a good person. The front of the Sedre represent the future and the back of the Sedre represent the past. So you wearing representing the present. The back pouch is symbolically the storehouse of potential good deeds, which the front pouch is symbolically the pocket of the good deeds when you are actively working and activating those good deeds. That's why you are wearing it. But on top of the Sidre, we are going to wear Kushti. Now, what is Kushti? Kushti literally is just like a long wool strands. It's just sometimes come in 2 meters, 2.5, or something for a huge adult is going to come 3+ meters. This strand is being woven by those wool, by the sheep's hair. And then it's been coming from the 12 times 6, 72 tiny, tiny, tiny strands of the wool sheep. So then it's being woven together as it's been woven with a very certain skills. At the end, they are just to keep making a knot and it only remaining with the 3 tassels. When they're creating those knots, there's a 3 things is left there. These 3 represent of our 3 divine of our religion, which is good thoughts, good words, and good deeds. But the question is that, why even this long strands? Why even we are wearing it on top of our sedrim? The main thing that this cord, it was like a past, they were wearing like a belt. When the people were going for, again, farming or agriculture or hunting, they were wearing a belt with all those tools they were hanging on top of that. But instead, we are, as a Zoroastrian, just wearing it, reminding that our Zoroastrian religion is the religion of the peace. And this is such a delicate material that we are wearing it. And then again, the 72 strands of this sheep's wool, it's and somehow is a combination of 6 times 12, which 72, it is reminding of the 72 chapters of Yasna, where Gatha, Zartosh's work, is being hidden among this 72 chapter. In another session, I'm going to say how it's been hidden. There is a 5 section of that Gatha that are smart and brilliant, Mubedan and our ancestor. After a couple of times that Gatha has been burned in all the Skender and everything, they came back and they hide it between those 72 chapters of Yasna so it can be saved. But at the same time, these 12 represent of the 12 months that we have. And the 6 represent the 6 Gahambar. Sometimes you are saying it, what is Gahambar? Gahambar is more like a fist. It's more like a Thanksgiving, that at that time, 6 times of the year, our people were gathering together and they were sharing their harvest. And then they were sharing among those people that unfortunately that year was not a success year for their farming and agriculture. Let's say that this year it was good for wheat, but it was not good for the fruit. Or it was for some certain fruit, but some certain fruit, unfortunately, they couldn't harvest and having good one. So instead of having us like one Thanksgiving, which is very fancy and luxury and all of us gathering and eating food, they were really coming, bringing their stuff and sharing among each other. So that it means Gahambar. So 12 times 6 is 72. That's another symbol for that. And then as I mentioned at the end, it has a three tassels, which is representing of three divine principles of a religion, which is good thoughts, good words, and good deeds. And now you're saying it, okay, how I'm wearing this koshti on top of my sidre. It's like you are circling three times around your waist. But then how you're doing it. So first you're putting, if I can show with the hand, first you're going to divide this with your hand, not exactly dividing it. You're dividing that one with your middle finger. And then from the middle of that koshti, you're putting on the center of your belly. And then you're going to go into the back, twisting and then bringing it to your front. When you're bringing to your front, you're doing it like a, you're putting, you're putting it like a knot. The knot that you are making it, making sure that you are putting more like a navy knot, which I mean, there is a video which I can share at the end, and Artemis can share with you guys. So first you are putting, for example, if this is a strand, you are putting that the left on the top of the right, and then the right is going to go in the middle of the circle, tying it. And then next time you are putting a right on top of the left, and the left strand is goes in the middle. Why we are making like a navy knot? Because it's going to be every time easy to just untie it every day that we are just wearing the sidre and koshti. So two in the front and in the back, the same thing, two in the back that we are doing it. So four knots that we are making and securing this koshti around our sidre. What are, why four? And you're saying that we're always talking about three, which is three divine, true. But four is this for a reason. One is existing of one God and our religion that we are praising for a God as a monotheism. Second, that acceptance of the legitimacy that this Zoroastrian is a religion and is faith and it has a prophet and a book. The third one, that the prophet is Ashur Zartosh and we accepting the prophecy of him. And the fourth, it comes back again to those three divine of religion, of good thoughts, good words, and good deeds. So these four knots is happening and securing this koshti around our waist. And when for the first time, if anyone are going to get initiated to this religion, they are going to go to a sidre koshti ceremony, which is someone who is wise and mature and is full aware of this religion is going to initiate, and the person who admitting to be part of this religion is tying this koshti around his waist on top of the sidre. Sometimes it happens individually, sometimes it happens as a group. And then from the moment that you are wearing this particular garment, you're coming to this beautiful community of Zoroastrian, and you can practice at any time that you wish. If there is any question, I would like just to answer before I'm starting the Avesta. Yes, go ahead. I cannot hear you.
Please unmute yourself, Lily, and
yes,
then ask.
I'm trying.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
You said these four knots representing four things. One is there is one God, and the second one accepting Zoroastrian as a religion, and the third one again. It was Zoroastra as a messenger, and the third one the three good thought. Is it? You know, is that right what I said, or you said something else?
No, that's exactly it. So I put it over here in front of you on this page as well. So acceptance of the existence of one
Oh,
God,
okay. Okay.
acceptance of the legitimacy of the Zoroastrian religion and the faith, acceptance
Yeah.
of the prophecy of Ashvatthar Spentamon, and acceptance of the three divine principles of religion, good thoughts, good
Yeah,
hopes, and
it was very small. I couldn't see it. Thank you for clarifying.
Absolutely.
Lily, I'll post the files that Nushin is sharing in our WhatsApp group. So you'll have it in the WhatsApp group today as well. Thank you for your question.
Okay. If there is no other further question, let's go back and start our Avesta. As usual, we are going to start with Ashem Bahu Yatahu. You can mute or unmute yourself, and then we are going to go particularly to this together, and then we are going to start the new Avesta today. Ashem Bahu Vaishem Asti Ushta Asti Ushtah moi Yadashoi Vaishtoyashem Yatohu Vairyo Ataratosh Shauchi Hacha Vangyosh Dazomanangho Shiaut nanom angheosh mazdai Shatrim chaurai Imdre gubiu dadat vastarem. Okay, let's go to the Avestai Koshti Afzun. We finished Surush Vaj last time. And now we are going to come for the prayer for tying the Koshti. So let me put in the presentation mode so it's big enough for people to see it. So as we practicing in the past, I'm first reciting the first page with some meaning, and then I'm gonna come back. If anyone volunteers just to do it, they can do it. Otherwise, I'm reciting, you can repeat after me. Avestaye Koshti Afson, prayers for tying Koshti. Bename Urmazde Bakhshayande Bakhshayeshgare Mehban. In the name of Ahura Mazda, who is forgiven, merciful, and kind. Humato, Uchto, Hovarshto, Manishnio, Goveshnio, Koneshnio, Tanio, Ravonio, Gitio, Menu, Ajesh, Hamaguna, Vanahi, Avokhsho, Pashimano, Pe Patet Hom. It's interesting in Farsi, all these O-O, it means and. And that's why it just keeps saying it like and. And the sentence will be over when it has a period or full stop here. But what it says, Humato huchto hovarshto. That's another thing, is a good mind, good thoughts, good words, good deeds. Manishnyo, Govishnyo, Koneshni. That's another different way of saying Manishni, man, mind, is all about, again, good thoughts. Govishni, Guftar, it means all about the good words. Koneshni, Konesh, Vakonesh, it means like, our deeds and our words. So it's all, they're saying it in two different language, in two different versions, with the good thoughts, good words, and good deeds. Tanio, in Farsi, tan, it means body. Ravonio, my soul. Something physical, something non-physical. Gitio, it means this word, which is, this word is not eternal. And menu means our eternal world, where we are going and belonging to that. So by body and soul in the physical and spiritual world. This one is saying that ازش همه گونه و ناهی اواخش و پشیمان و پپتتم from whatever I made committed and I did a wrongful action or words or deeds I'm regretted I'm just right now claiming it that I'm committing that I did mistake so I repent for the sins which have been committed by me I'm honestly sorry so now with my good thoughts good words good deeds within this world or that world with my body and my soul I'm admitting and I'm sorry for what I have done. اجهر جسته و گفته و کرده و منیده و شنیده و پرموده اجش همه گونه و ناهی اواخش و پشیمان و پی پتتم. Again, another version that they are saying it in Farsi. If anything that it just, it means it came to my mind like a sparking, or I said, or I did, or again, manida, one more time, I've been thinking, considering, or I heard those bad stuff, or I did bad stuff. Again, I'm extremely sorry for that, and I'm regretted for that. So let's go back and then you guys can repeat after me. به نام or if you want you can unmute. If you don't, that's fine. I can doing it one more time slowly and move on. به نام اورمزد بخشاینده بخشایشگر مهربان حومت و پخت و هوشت و منشنی و گوشنی و گوشنی و کنشنی و تنی و روانی و گیتی و مینی عجش همگونه و ناهی اواخش و پشیمان و پی پتت هم You can stop me if you have any question. اجهر جسته و گفته و کرده و منیده و شنیده و پرموده اجش همگونه و ناهی اواخش و پشیمان و پی پتت هم. Okay. Now we are going to come here, assuming that I have my koshti in my hand. And this is the way that I'm just splitting it between my hand. One hand that I'm putting like this, the one that it has all the tassels, I'm putting it like a parallel to the ground. The other hand, it's keep going beneath that one. And this is the practice that I'm doing it 3 times. شکست اهریمن باد. شکست اهریمن باد. شکست اهریمن باد. May evil be destroyed 3 times. شکست او, then I'm keeping my hand still here. شکست او زده باد گناه مینوی دوروند ابا هما دیوان و دروژان و جادویان گجسته تک تا قار دوزخ نگونه و نگونسار مرگ بن. هیچ کارشان به کامل نبود. From here, the both hand comes upward. So far, I'm saying it. I wish that the evil they destroyed, everything that they did, it was wrong. They are just adding and then making the people to commit it to that sin, or everything to be away from me. These are all the stuff that I'm putting it down. But from here, now I'm going to go to the positive. هر کار و کرفه اشویی که بود, which is coming here. هر کار و کرفه اشویی که بود به کامه اورمزد خدا و امشاسپندان پیروزگر. May all evil be destroyed, may all good perform be in accord with the wish of Ahura Mazda. That's a simple thing that is going to come the last three sentences. هست و بودش به کامه باد دین پاک اورمزد. When we are saying over here, هست و بودش به کامه باد دین پاک اورمزد. And from here, I'm ready just to tie around my waist. May the religion of Ahura Mazda always survive. So after here, here is the next section. Maso Baho Piruz Garbad. Maso Baho Piruz Garbad Dadar Urmazde Rayumande Harumande Harves Aga. Shnaotra Ahurae Mazdao Taroi Diti Angrahe Mainyeush Haitia Varshtam Vasna Pra Shotemen Staumi Ashen. The pleasing of Ahura Mazda and the disgrace of Bath is in accord with the will of virtuous people. So at this time, right now, I just put this koshti like two times around my waist. Now here is the time that I'm knotting it. So this knotting is exactly, you're saying it one, two, one. This four knots exactly is happening it. Shnautra urai mazal, shembo vaishtamasi ushto asi ushto ahmahi adashai vaishto yashem. Here in Yato Ahu, when I'm just putting two times, I'm calling the ushto, that I'm going to go ahead and then tying it. Yato Ahu vairi, atarato, sha chi pacha, vangeosh, dazda, manangeosh, yaut nana. انکهوش مزدای شطرم چو اورای آین رگو بیو دادت واسدارم. So two times I'm here, I'm putting it two knots. And this Ashen Vahu at the end, I have to fast doing it with those two ushta and I'm tying it in the back. Ashen Vahu Vahishtam Asi, ushta Asi, ushta Ahmai, Heyat Ashai Vahishtai Ashen. At the end of this page, this kushti is being tied around my waist on top of my sidra. And now here is going to come to the beauty of what I'm committing it to Ahura Mazda, particularly to myself. So let me recite this one, and then we are going to also listen to that, to the track. Mazda yasno ahmi. Mazda yasno zaratostrish. I, with my appreciations and convictions, choose for myself to be a worshiper of the wise one and a Zoroastrian. Fravarone ostutascha. Fravare tascha. Ostuye homatem منو از توی پختم وچو از توی هوارشتم شیاتنم. It's what exactly astuye, it means I praise and I appreciate. Homat, remember another way we were saying it, homatem mano is all about good mind or good thoughts. Astuye, I praise, I appreciate. Puch, all those say that I'm saying it or good words. Astuye, I appreciate, I praise. All the good deeds, whatever I committed. Hovashtem shiatim. Astuye da'enam vanguhim mazdayasnim fraspaya o chizram nizasnei pishem. Quiet vadatam اشعانی یا هایتینام چا بوش ینتینام چا مزیشتا چا وهیشتا چا سرشتا چا یا آهوریش زرتشتش. I appreciate good conscience, the religion of worshipping the wise one, which overthrows yokes, yet sets swords, teaches self-reliance, and it's righteous. Therefore, of the religions that have been and that shall be, this is the greatest, best, and sublimest. It's divine and Zarathustrian. So let's, before we are continuing it, let's listen to the track and then we can come back. If you want, we can repeat this section together. So if Artemision, if you can please play the track, that would be good.
You have to stop the screen share so I can share.
Mazda yasno zaratoshri paravarane ostu tascho paravare tascho ostu ye umatem mano ostu ye datom ashoni yo haitinam cha bush yaintinam cha mazishta cha vaishta cha sraishta cha yahurish zarato Yasnuish astuitish astuitish.
استوارم به کیش مزدیسنی که آورده زرتشت است. می ستایم اندیشه نیک را، می ستایم گفتار نیک را، می ستایم کردار نیک را، می ستایم دین نیک مزدیسنی که یوغ بردگی را بر می اندازد و جنگفزار را فرو می نهد که آزادی بخش و راستین است و از تمام دین هایی که هستند و خواهند بود مهترین، بهترین و زیباترین است.
With my appreciations and convictions, choose for myself to be a worshipper of the Wise One and a Zarathustrian. I appreciate good thoughts. I appreciate good words. I appreciate good deeds. I appreciate good conscience, the religion of worshipping the Wise One, which overthrows yokes yet sheaths swords, teaches self-reliance and is righteous. Therefore, of the ways of life that have been and that shall be, this is the greatest, best, and sublimest. It is divine and Zarathustrian.
Thanks. Okay. Let me know if you wanted to repeat that section of Avesta or you got it. I'm flexible either way.
I just have a question, Nushin. Is there a section where we kind of make two loops in the kushti, or is it or that is just depends on the person's preference?
No, so the time when we are wearing that really kushti is exactly is going to start from this page when we are saying it from the shikast ahriman bot, right? So prior to that, let's start from the beginning. So this is avesta kushti afsun. From here, you are untying your kushti because you've been wearing it and then you had it from the day before, right? Or from the goh before. So from the very beginning of this one, when you are just saying it, benam urmazde bakhshande, you're just untying it and making it ready. When it comes to this section, shikast ahriman bot, now you have untied kushti in your hand and then you're keeping it. And then from here is going to start from shikast ahriman bot. The hand goes down. You are keep doing it. Shikast ahriman bot. Shikast ahriman bot. Shikast ahriman bot. And you're just reciting this one all the way to this page. From here, masovaho piruzgar bot. Now it's going to come to that you're really practicing. You're putting it first three times here, bringing it down. You're going to go around your waist. And then you're just making it exactly equal from both sides when you're reading and reciting this section. When it's going to come from Hashem Vahu, Yata Ahu, and this Hashem Vahu, now you're making these four knots. At the end of this page, this kushti has been fully secured, is on the top of your sidre, and then you're done with that. Now the rest of this prayer, which is going to come from here, is all about your commitment, is all about one more time you're reminding that you appreciate all those three divine good thoughts, good words, good deeds. You're going to start practicing it. And this is another way of commitment that you're saying it. And you're appreciating, you're praising it, all those one, and then you'll continue doing it. From this page, it's you're done with that, the physical action of that time question is all about commitment now.
Could you explain also why do we make the two knots with Xiao Tanana?
Why we are making or when we are making? Why?
No, so, why are we making the two knots with the word Xiao Tanana?
I exactly don't know why is that. I have no idea. I don't know why with the Xiao Tanana that we are putting it one knot and the other one here on the front of two and in the back with the words of Ushta. I don't know why they chose or why we are picking it. I don't have the answer for that. But I know that when we are doing the Shiot Nanom, we are doing like a navy, one side left and one side right, two in the front and two in the back. But I can find out for you. I can ask from someone.
Thank you, Nishin.
So if you guys already clear on this one and we don't want to repeat it because also we've learned from the track, I can move on unless that you or Lily John wants me to repeat it. Okay. So I think that you guys are good to go. I can go to the next page. This one is also is good that you can really practice at any time. If you are having any hard time, if you're going to go to an exam, something, you want to do a presentation in front of audience, you want to say, God help me, God help me. You can really study when practicing this one and say, Jasame Avanke Mazda. Jasame Avanke Mazda. Jasame Avanke Mazda. Come to my help, O wise one, O Mazda. Amahe Hutosh Pahe Hura O Zahe Vere Raka. Nahe Ahura Zotahe Vanain Piascha Uparatoto Tvo Shahe Hazotahe Zervanahe Akaranahe Zervanahe Darego. May all creations of Ahura Mazda be praised. It's interesting that one of those kids, one time they were saying that we are saying so many words and just this simple language. And I said, well, definitely, I don't have any better translation for each and every word. And I want to be stick to that accuracy, but all probably are mentioning regarding different creatures. We make sure that we are not just praising human, we are praising all the creation, which at one time I'm going to talk in a Ramshas Pandan. All the creation, including water, plant, sky, earth, wind, and then also fire. So these are all the creation of Ahura Mazda that we as a human, we have to make sure that we are not abusing or hurting. We are not abusing or killing animals for no reason. We are not polluting water or sky or earth. So these are all something that we as a human, which are the last creation of Ahura Mazda, we are committing to that. So again, here we are going to come and then we are praising all the creation of the God. Hashem Bahu Vaishtam Asti, Ushta Asti, Ushta Ahmoi, Heyat Ashoi Vaishtoi Hashem. We have Hamazur Beam track as well, but I think that because I didn't tell you Artemision, we can either play next time, but I can go ahead and say this section. I think Hamazur Beam and then one last that we are finishing Avastai Koshi. But let's go together. Hamazur Beam is a very, very precious.
Nushinjan, before you start Hamazur Beam, Lily has a question.
Sure.
Yes, you know, on the previous one, it was Zervanahi. Is it referring to the religion that was at the time and before Zarathustra, Zervani?
I have no idea. I know that this is Zervanahi, but I don't know. I can definitely, it's a good question. I never knew that.
Okay, thank you.
Uh, Hamazurbim, it's something is very interesting for Farsi people. They know what is Hamazur means. It means being together and then pushing it together. But then in reality, all we are saying is we need it to be one team. In our corporate, they are saying it one team, one power, and that's going to be more powerful and strong. And that's what here they are advertising, or I should emphasizing on that. And so many of our also invitation nowadays, when it's coming from our Zoroastrian community, we are saying, let's be together, let's hamozurbim. It means that we have to be together to make it something happen. So again, it's very simple from that Farsi language people, but then if it's not, then I'm going to make it simple in the translation. Hamozurbim. Hamozure. هما اشوبیم هما زور ویش کرفه بیم هم کرفه کرفه کاران بیم دورش و ناه و ناه کاران بیم هم کرفه بسته کشتیان و نیکان و وهان هفت Kishwar Zamin Bim. Here said, let's be together. Let's be together to doing a good stuff. Ashu means everything that is following the Asha's rule. Asha is the rule that is guiding the entire world and is all about righteousness. Hamazure Vish Kirfabim. If you remember from Koshti, on the front of the Sidri, it was one rectangle, which we are calling it kirfa. And the back was gurde. The semicircle gurde is all the potential good deeds. And then the front one, it was kirfa. It means something that we activated that good deeds. And then we really made it happen. So let's be with those people that they are doing good deeds that is going to come in. That's why it keeps saying kirfa. Ham kirfa ye kirfa koran bin. Being with those people that they're doing those good stuff, and then exactly simply just copy paste what they are doing it. Durajvana means be away from all those sin and then those people that they're committing to the sin. Vana in another way is a guna, guna and guna karan. Ham kirfaya basta kushtiano and be with those people that they are tying the kushti. And they are nik, it means that they are kind people or doing and committing for the good stuff. Within the seven different, at that time, they were thinking that the entire world was breaking it down in seven different empire. So let's be with all the seven, the civilian and the population of seven different country around the world or area in the world. So another one they are saying, again, maybe we joined in strength. Maybe we stand united through righteousness. Maybe we join hands in doing more good deeds. Maybe we unite with good people. Maybe we far from wrong and wrongdoers. Maybe we join hand in hand with all the faithful and all the good people of the world. This is very powerful, and because we are practicing so much among our kids are learning the collaboration, being together, accepting the differences, yet understanding and then making something good happens together. It is such a powerful prayer, to be honest. I don't know if Artemis, you have that track right now. We can listen. If not, since I forgot to tell you, that's fine. We can doing it next time.
I can quickly find it if you like, or we can do it next time, whatever you like.
We can do it next time, because again, this is a good prayer. Even if those people that they missed it today and they're listening it, it would be great one more time to come to Hamozurbim. But I know that we have like a couple more minutes. I can finish this Avesta with the last page. Besare, and these are very, very Farsi. Those people that has a Farsi language, they kind of understanding it. به سر گذر چینوت پل بزرگ. It's as the Muslim people, they are saying it, there is a bridge, they're calling it Sarat Bridge. In Zoroastrian, they are saying it Chinevat Bridge. به سر گذر چینوت پل بزرگ سبک و خرم و شاد و آسان من ودوارنی یاد آداروم است. When I'm passing from the bridge with all the committed of my good stuff, good deeds and everything, I hope that I can be easily passed from that bridge. Again, these are all symbolically they're talking about. There is no physical bridge, there is no nothing, but it's all about when our soul is just going to leave this world and it's going to go to the eternal. It's going to be flying away so lightly, so gently that it's done its mission in this world. او آن فشم اخوان اشوان روشن گروسمان هما خاره من عبر رساد یاد آدار اون است. O Creator God, help us pass over the great bridge of discernment in light, easy, happy and smooth way. O Creator God, maybe we reach the best of both of the righteous, the bright practice full of comfort. And the rest is just one more time. We are saying it. Hashem Bahu Vaishta Masi Ushta Asti Ushta Ahmai Heyat Ashai Vaishta Yashem Hiruz Bad Kharo Avijah Vahdine Mazdi Asnan Hiruz Bad Kharo Avijah وحدین مازی اسنان پیروز باد خراوی جه وحدین مازی اسنان. May the special glory of the good religion of Mazda worship be victorious. اشم با و اشتمستی اوشتا استی اوشتا احمایی هید اشای و اشتایی اشم پور مزد و امشاز پندان کامه باد ایدون باد ایدون ترج باد. May God and the eternal progressive be successful, may be so, may be more so. I do both, may be, I do touch both, may be more so. Amshaspandan, next time I'm going to cover this Amshaspandan. I'm going to go more in details. What does that mean? That you'll keep hearing it in more of our Avesta. We are finishing one more time. Hashem Bahu Vaishtamasti, Ushta Asti, Ushta Ahmai. Hope you guys had a great time. It was a good Sunday morning starting with this Avesta. And thank you so much for listening and being in this class.
Thank you so much, Nushin, for having the class. Thank you, Lily, for joining us. Until next time.
Thanks, everyone. Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.